हेलो चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ ईश्वरचंद बलिचवाल वेलकम्स ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर सेकेंड चैप्टर पॉलिनोमियल्स। नाउ वी फैक्टराइज दिस पॉलिनोमियल बाय यूजिंग आइडेंटिटीज। ओके, नाउ हियर वी ट्राई टू कन्वर्ट दिस इनटू दिस फॉर्म। 36a² + 84ab + 49b² Now we can write this 36a² as 6a² 84ab 2 into 6a into 7b plus here 49b² as 7b². How? So first we learn how we write this polynomial in this form. Here we can see 36a². This is 36a² can be written as 6a². Okay, because 6a into 6a is 36a². Therefore we can write this. 84ab. Before write this, first we learn how we write 49b² as 7b² okay, because 7b into 7b 47 49b² okay. By these two terms here, this is 6a, this is 7b. Consider these two terms as first term and this is second term. Okay, so just write here twice, first term and this is second term. Okay, by this way you can convert these into this type of expression. Okay, so by this way here 6a² comes from this, and 6a and 7b by this first and second term, this is twice 6a into 7b. If we multiply this, we get 84ab. 6, 7, 42 into 2, 84. And AB here. Okay? So, we can write this as this. Okay? So, by comparing given expression with identity first, what is our identity first? x square plus 2xy plus y square. This is our identity. Now, I repeat, x plus y whole square is x square plus 2xy plus y square. Okay? This is our first identity. So, with the help of this, we compare this by this. So, x equal to 6a, because this is 6a whole square. So here x square means x equal to 6a, y equal to 7b. Okay, consider them as first and second term. Okay, with the help of this we can write. So with the help of identity first, we get this as 6a plus 7b whole square. How? First we convert this as this. So here x equal to 6a, y equal to 7b. Okay, so this is 6a plus 7b whole square. So we can write directly 6a plus 7b whole square. Okay, and 6a plus 7b whole square means we write this twice, 6a plus 7b into 6a plus 7b. So this is our factors. Okay, now we take one more example here. 36/9 x² minus y² upon 16. This can be written as 36 is 6 whole square. What 6 whole square is 36, so we write 6 whole square. 9 as 3 whole square. Because 3 into 3, 9, 6 into 6, 36. And x² can be written as x whole square. And here y whole square upon this 16 can be written as 4 whole square. Because 4 4 is 16. Now this reduce as this. Now make these term as whole square term, single term. So how can we convert this? 6 by 3 x. This is 6 by 3 x whole square. Okay? So write this term as a single term. Here y by 4 whole square. Okay? Now this polynomial reduces as this. Okay? Now comparing it with identity third. What is our identity? Third, x square minus y square equal to x plus y into x minus y. Okay? This is our third identity, which we learned in last session. Okay? So this converted into this form. Okay? This a square minus this square, which is comparing by this, and we can write down this as x and this as y. So place of x and y, we just put this as x and this as y. So we can consider this as x and this as y. The complete whole term consider as y, this complete whole term consider as x. So on the place of x and y, we just put these terms. So x 6x by 3, y this is y by 4, x this is 6x by 3, and y y by 4. Okay? Because one time here plus and the other time here minus. So this is our factor. So the factorization of this is like this. So by using identity, it is very easy to factorize any polynomial. Okay? So remember different identities and practice to convert this. Now we take other identities. Okay? In last session, we take four identities. This is our fifth identity. The fifth identity is x plus y plus z whole square equals x square plus y square plus z square plus twice xy plus twice yz plus twice zx. Okay? This is our fifth identity. First we learn how we get this identity. X plus y plus z whole square can be written as x plus y plus z into x plus y plus z. Here there are two power, so we put them two times. Okay? Now multiply this whole term to this each term. Okay? X multiply was with this x plus y plus z, then y multiply with x plus y plus z, and then z multiply with x plus y plus z. So first we write it in exponent form like this. X into this whole term, y into this whole term, plus z into this whole term. Okay? First we write like this, then we open the brackets, then what happened? This x multiplied with x and with y and with z. Same here, okay? So multiply x into x, x square, x into y, xy, x into z, xz, y into x can be written as xy. First we write x, then vy. Y into y, y square, y into z, yz, now z into x, xz, z into y, yz, and z into z, z square. Okay? So after open these brackets, we get this. Now check what are the similar terms, add them. Here, first we separate the square term, this x square, this y square, and this z square. We write first, okay? Now, xy and xy, twice xy, so we write twice xy, because both the term having same sign, so we are adding. Now, xz and xz also having the same sign, so we adding them, and we get twice xz can be written as zx, and this yz and this yz also same sign, so we add them and we get twice yz. Okay, so this can be written as this. So our identity become in this form: x plus y plus z whole square equals x square plus y square plus z square plus twice xy plus twice yz plus twice zx. So memorize this identity. So by help of this, by comparing this, we can factorize any other problems. Okay, this is our fifth identity. Now we expand this. With the help of this, we learn how to expand this polynomial with the help of this identity. Okay, so here is our identity and here our polynomial. Okay, comparing this expression with x plus y plus z whole square, that is this identity here, x plus y plus z whole square. So when we compare what is the value of x here and what is the value of y here and what is the value of z here, we just write down the values of x, y, z and we get the solution directly. So first we compare here. 4a is as x, so we can write x equal to 4a. Now here minus twice b, this complete term with this sign also we write as y equal to minus twice b. Okay, because we compare this which having plus sign, but here negative sign, so with sign we place here z equal to minus 3c, because this z and this is minus 3c, so we just write place of z, we can write minus 3c. Therefore using identity fifth, we have, this is our identity fifth. Okay, so this is the whole square of this and here x plus y z whole square, so we write like this and we put the values of x, y, z here. Okay, so we directly get the solution. So 4a minus 2b minus 3c whole square can be written as this is, make a bracket here, so we can consider easily 4a as x plus, this can be write as minus twice b, write as plus and minus twice b in the bracket, so this is y. Now minus 3c as plus and in the bracket minus 3c, so this become z. So this expression can be written in the form of this. So we compare this term as x, this term as y, this term as z by comparing this to this identity. Okay, now these values putting in this expression. Okay, so x square here 4a whole square, because x value of x is this and the value of y is this, so y square minus twice b whole square, this is z, so z square means minus 3c whole square, plus look here twice xy, so this is x, this is y, twice xy, okay, plus twice yz, this is y and this is z, so twice yz. Now twice zx, here is the twice z and x, z minus 3c, x 4a, okay. So by this putting these values, we get the factorization of this. Now solve this. 4a whole square means 4a into 4a, that is 4 just 16, a into a square. Okay, now here minus 2 into minus 2 plus 4, b into b square. Okay, here minus 3 into minus 3 plus 9, c into c square. Okay, now multiply these terms, 2 4 ja 8, 8 2 ja 16, and here minus, here plus, so minus into plus, minus. Here 2, 2 ja 4, 3 ja 12, but minus into minus, plus. So this is 12 BC, B into C here, 12 BC. Now multiply this, 4, 3 ja 12 into 2, 24, and this plus into minus, minus. So this become 24 AC, okay? So this way we can write this as this. This is our solution. So this way we can, using identity, and get our solution directly. Now factorize this. This is the converse of that, because here the expanded form is already written. 4x square plus y square plus z square minus 4xy minus twice yz plus 4xz. First, look here. These two terms having negative sign, but this term having positive sign, and our identity, we get all the signs positive. So first we decide ki how the negative signs comes. So first we check here, only this y term, any term containing y is negative, but the term containing x and z is positive. It means y is negative, due to y, negative sign of y here is the negative. So by keeping this thing in mind, we solve this. What is this? This 4x whole square can be written as twice x whole square. 2 2 ja 4, x into x, x square. This can be written as this. Y square can be written as minus y. Why we put minus here? Because here we check that in both these terms there is a negative sign, but this term having positive sign. It means x and z are positive, but y is negative. So we place here negative sign. The whole square of minus y. Here z whole square. Now, with the help of these terms, consider this as first term, this as second term, and this as third term. Because here what we do? Check. X plus y plus z whole square is our identity, and this is the whole square of first term, this is the whole square of second term, or this is the whole square of third term, and this is twice first and second term, first and second term, this is twice second and third term, okay, and this is twice third and first term, third and first term, okay. So by this way we write here and consider these three as first, second, third term. So write twice first term, twice x, second term minus y. So put here. Now twice second term minus y, third term z. Here twice, this is first term and this is third term, okay. This is second term, this is first term, okay. By this way we write, this expression can be right by this way, and check whether the values are correct or not. 2 2 ja 4 into this minus, minus 4xy, okay, this is minus 4xy, okay, that's why this is correct. Here twice minus yz, so this is minus twice yz, because this minus into plus, this is minus 2yz, okay. 2 2 ja 4 x and this z, so we can write this, okay. Now put this whole expression in the short form, that is as here. This is our identity fifth, and write down this as this form. But now we make the converse of this. This can be written as this, so we write this as a short form. This is our x, so put here twice x. This is our y, so put here minus y. Why we call this x? Because this is first term. In the identity, the first term is x. So here the first term, either saying x, say this is first term, this is second term, this is third term. And we write here first term plus second term plus third term whole square. So put here twice x, put here minus y, put here z, okay, and place here whole square. Now simplify this. This is 2x, this plus into minus, minus y, and this is z. 2x minus y plus z whole square, okay. Now here the square, so write this two times, twice x minus y plus z into twice x minus y plus z. This is our solution. So by this way we can solve factorized problem, okay. First we make them whole square of these three terms, and with these three terms we change this into this form, and then write this whole expression as first plus second plus third terms whole square. So we get the solution. Okay, now we take next problem. Here our identity 6, x plus y whole cube equals x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. So first we solve how this identity comes. Here is our x plus y whole cube. So x plus y whole cube means x plus y into x plus y into x plus y. X plus y multiplying 3 times. So here we write x plus y and the 2 times of x plus y, that is x plus y whole square. So 2 and 1, 3. Why we write this as this? Because we have already know the value of x plus y whole square with the help of identity first. Okay, our identity first is what? X plus y whole square equal to x square plus twice xy plus y square. This is our identity first. So with the help of this, we can expand this in this form. So we expand here x plus y, and we just write x plus y whole square with the help of identity here. X square plus twice xy plus y square. Now multiply this with this. Okay. X with this whole term. This x multiply with the whole term. And this y also multiply this whole term. Whole term means whole bracket. So first we multiply this x with this whole bracket like this. Then we multiply this y with this whole bracket and putting the same sign as here. Okay. This way we multiply this. Okay. Now multiply this x with this, x with this, and x with this. And same here, this y multiply by these whole three terms and check. X into x square, x cube, x into twice xy, twice x into x, x square y, twice x square y, x into y square, xy square. Here, y x square can be written as x square y, so it is x square y. Twice xy into y, this is twice xy square, because we multiply this y here. So this is twice xy square, y into y square, y cube, okay. By open this bracket, we get this. Okay. Now, check. Add the similar terms. Here, we check that x square y and x square y. These are the similar terms. So, we add them and write here 3x square y. This xy square, this xy square are similar terms and having same sign. So, we write these as addition of the 3xy square and 3x square y. And put this y cube here. First we write the highest powers. This is 3 and this is 3, so we put highest powers here, then the lower power. Means we write the expression in descending order, okay. So this here. Now check in both these terms 3xy, 3xy is common. So we take 3xy is common. So what left? Here x square, so here left x, here y square, so we get here y. So this can be write as this. So this is our identity. X plus y whole cube can be written as x cube plus y cube plus 3xy multiplied with x plus y. This is our identity 6. So memorize this and directly use by making like this. We directly use this. So this is very helpful to solve our problem. Now the identity 7, x minus y whole cube. This can be written as x minus y 3 times. Okay, and this is our identity. So first we take the help of x minus y whole square, can be written as x square minus twice xy plus y square. This is the identity second. Expansion of this x minus y whole square. So we take help by this identity, because this can be written as x minus y into x minus y whole square. Because the here 3 power, here 2 and the here 1. So 2 plus 1, 3. So x minus y whole cube can be written as this. Now open this with the help of this identity. X minus y become x square minus twice xy plus y square. Like this. Okay. Now multiply this whole bracket with x and y. One time with x and one time with y. When we multiply this x by this whole bracket, we get this. Then put the negative sign and multiply this y with this whole bracket. Okay. Now open the bracket. So we multiply separately. Okay. Here we multiply separately with the sign. Okay. So here x into x square, x cube minus, so minus twice xy into x. Twice x square y, x is double, so minus twice x square y, x into y square, xy square. Now, minus y into x square, so minus y x square, minus into minus plus, so y into twice xy square. This minus into this plus is minus, so y into y square, y cube. Now, rearrange them here. X cube minus 2x square y plus xy square. This yx square can be written as x square y 2xy square minus y cube. Now check where is the similar term. If there may be some similarity, then we add or subtract them. Here twice x square y and x square y, these are the same term having the same sign, so we adding them and the sign is same. So twice x square y minus x square y become minus 3x square y, and xy square plus twice xy square also the same terms having the same sign, so we add them. Xy square twice xy square become 3xy square, and this y minus y cube here. Now check what is the common here. 3xy, so minus 3xy we taking common. Because whatever the sign here, first we take that sign. And then check what is left here. Here the minus sign. So minus into plus minus. So we put here plus. And what left? 3xy. This square x as here. Because when we divide this x square y by this xy, we get the x. And converse of this. By multiplying these two terms, we get this. So this is left here. Now check. After taking common 3xy, what left here? Y. So put y. And by taking negative as common, negative. And this negative become positive. So here we write negative sign. Okay. By dividing this plus sign with this minus, we get this minus. And this y cube. Okay. So this is our expression reduce as h. So this can be write as this y cube plus here. So this is a descending form and this right here. So our identity reduce as h, x minus y whole cube can be in the expanded form x cube minus y cube minus 3xy into x minus y. Okay, this is our identity 7. So memorize it. Okay, now we take other identity. This is our next identity. Identity 8. X cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz can be written as x plus y plus z, x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. So first we check how we can write this equal to this. So first we consider this, and by solving this, if we get this, so we understand that this can be write as this. So now this whole bracket multiplying by these three terms separately, x with this whole bracket, y with this whole bracket, and z also with this whole bracket. So we write here x into this whole bracket like this, plus y into this whole bracket, plus z into this whole bracket. Now solve x multiplying with each and every terms with sign. So multiply x into x square, x cube, x into y square, xy square, x into z square, xz square, x into minus xy become minus x square y, x into this y minus yz become minus xyz, this x into this minus zx become minus zx square, this minus zx square. Now y into x square y, first we write x square, then we write y, y into y square, y cube, y into z square, yz square, and here y into minus xy, xy square, this is minus xy square, y into minus yz, minus y square z, y into minus zx, so this become yzx, xyz whole theta. Now open this zx square, zy square, zy square, z cube, z into minus xy become xyz, minus xyz, z into yz, yz square, z into minus zx, this become minus z square x. So by open this bracket, by multiplying these, we get this. Now check here x cube, y cube, and z cube, which are here. And this xy square and this xy square having the different sign, so they are cancelled. This xz square, we found the xz, here the xz. Xz square, z square, x one and the same thing. Xz square, here the z square, here z square, and having the different sign, so this is cancelled out. X square y, this is negative, this is positive, so cancel. Zx square and zx square, this is negative, this is positive, so cancel. Yz square minus yz square, different sign, so this is cancel. Minus y square z plus y square z, different sign, so this is cancel. What left? Xyz minus xyz minus xyz minus xyz. So this is minus 3xyz. So by solving this, we get this, and this is same as this. So we can write this identity as x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz equals x plus y plus z into x square plus y square plus z square minus xy minus yz minus zx. This is our identity at. So memorize this. And by comparing this, this can be written as this, and this can be written as this, vice versa. Okay? So using this, now we take some example. Here, 3a plus 4b cube. Okay? This is our expression. Here, we compare this by our identity 6. What is our identity 6? X plus y whole cube equals x cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y. Compare this. Here x plus y cube, here 3a plus 4b whole cube. So here 3a is place of x and 4b is the place of y. So by comparing this, we can conclude x equal to 3a, y equal to 4b. Okay. So put the value of x, y in this by the help of this. So this can be write as this. Here the x cube means this 3a whole cube, y cube means और भी होल क्यूब, थ्री दिस थ्री एक्स थ्री ए वाई दिस फोर बी एंड एक्स दिस थ्री ए एंड वाई दिस फोर बी. तो बाई पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स वाई वी गेट दिस. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. थ्री ए क्यूब, थ्री थ्री जा नाइन, थ्री जा ट्वेंटी सेवन, ए इंटू ए इंटू ए क्यूब, फोर इंटू फोर सिक्सटीन, इंटू फोर सिक्सटी फोर, दिस इज बी क्यूब, थ्री थ्री जा नाइन, नाइन फोर जा थर्टी सिक्स, ए इंटू बी ए बी एंड दिस हियर. ओके, नाउ ओपन दिस ब्रैकेट. सो व्हाट वी गेट, दीज टू टर्म्स आर सिमिलर एंड थ्री ए मल्टीप्लाई विथ दिस थर्टी सिक्स ए बी, वी गेट वन जीरो एट ए इंटू ए स्क्वायर बी. ओके, नाउ थर्टी सिक्स इंटू फोर वन फोर्टी फोर एंड दिस ए बी इंटू बी ए बी स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज द अवर सॉल्यूशन ऑफ दिस. नाउ इवेल्युएट दिस. हियर वी हैव टू फाउंड द क्यूब ऑफ दिस नाइन 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 होल क्यूब. इफ वी मल्टीप्लाई थ्री टाइम देन इट इज वेरी टिपिकल टास्क, बट नाउ वी कैन राइट दिस एज दिस. वन थाउजेंड माइनस वन इज नाइन नाइन नाइन, सो दिस वी कैन बी राइट एज दिस बाई यूजिंग आइडेंटिटी सेवन. ओके, वट इज द आइडेंटिटी सेवन? एक्स माइनस वाई होल क्यूब इक्वल टू एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब माइनस थ्री एक्स वाई एंड एक्स माइनस वाई, दिस इज अवर आइडेंटिटी सेवन. सो हियर कंपेयरिंग दिस इज एक्स एंड दिस इज वाई, सो बाय पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स वाई इन दिस वी डायरेक्टली गेट दिस एक्स क्यूब. दिस इज एक्स क्यूब, एक्स इक्वल टू वन थाउजेंड, तो वन थाउजेंड क्यूब. दिस इज वाई क्यूब, वन क्यूब माइनस थ्री, हियर द एक्स, एक्स इक्वल टू वन थाउजेंड, वाई इक्वल टू वन एंड दिस इज एक्स वाई, एक्स इक्वल टू वन थाउजेंड, वाई इक्वल टू वन विद साइन वी पुटिंग द वैल्यू. ओके, नाउ सोल्व दिस. हियर द थ्री जीरो, सो वेन वी मेकिंग द क्यूब थ्री जीरो, थ्री जीरो एंड थ्री जीरो थ्री टाइम दैट इज नाइन जीरो, तो वी पुट नाइन जीरो हियर आफ्टर वन, दिस इज वन क्यूब एंड थ्री इंटू वन थाउजेंड थ्री थाउजेंड, दिस वन मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस थ्री विद थ्री. ओके, सो वी गेट बाई मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस थ्री टर्म्स थ्री थाउजेंड एंड दिस इज वन थाउजेंड माइनस वन. नाउ सोल्व, ओपन दिस ब्रैकेट. थ्री थाउजेंड इंटू वन थाउजेंड इज हियर थ्री जीरो, हियर थ्री जीरो, सो हियर सिक्स जीरो. ओके, एंड दिस माइनस इंटू दिस माइनस प्लस थ्री थाउजेंड इंटू वन थ्री थाउजेंड. नाउ फर्स्ट सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस विद दिस, दिस इज टू नाइन नाइन सेवन ट्रिपल जीरो एंड बाई एडिंग दिस एंड सब्ट्रैक्टिंग बाई दिस वी गेट दिस. दिस इज अवर सॉल्यूशन. ओके, तो बाई दिस वे वी कैन सॉल्व ए बिग प्रॉब्लम विद द यूजिंग ऑफ आइडेंटिटी. ओके, हैव ए नाइस डे.